Oh! I can't believe this. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Dominic the Primetime Treasure Hunter here. I am back down in the flood zone with an important update. So we have settled with the insurance company, and I have heard from my contractor, got the contract from him yesterday. So the good news is that the payment from the insurance company is going to pretty much cover all of the restructuring that we're going to do down here, the construction of the workbench that's going to go back here behind my green screen there. It's going to cover the installation of shelves. It's also going to cover tearing down this entire ceiling and just rewiring the lights that I put in here last year, and doing some adjustments to the ceiling as well. It's going to cover that, minus like $100. I'm going to be out for that. So now, of course, I did have a deductible. It was $1,000 deductible. So that wound up getting eaten up by, inventory costs and, some other losses and things. So that's just part of what happens when you're dealing with insurance. But, what I've got to do now, since I heard back from the contractor yesterday, I have the contract. I told him everything's all set. So I just need a start date from him, but that's going to happen soon. He's done many projects for me before, and the way he basically works is he just contacts me, and sometimes he's like, all right, I could just come over tomorrow, or I'll come over in 2 days, first thing in the morning, let me know. He's really reliable and responsible. So I know that email is going to be coming, or that text is going to be coming. So I've got to make sure that I've got inventory moved out of here. So one of the big things that I've been wanting to do for a long time is to work on this shelf right here. Now, this shelf has been stocked up with inventory for years, to the point that I do not know anymore what is inside these boxes. I could tell some of the stuff just based on looking on the edges, but like what's in that box down there, I don't know. What's on the bottom of those books there, I don't know. I just don't know. So you've heard of mystery unboxings. Well, I'm just going to call this a mystery unshelving. So we're just going to pull this stuff off and see what we can find in there. I'll make some decisions, I'm sure, on some things that I see that I immediately want to get up and list just because they're exciting to me. But if you see anything along the way that you like as well and you want me to list, just let me know. That will help me out. I'll put it up. There's no requirement to purchase it or anything. Just, just let me know you're potentially interested in it, and I'll make it a priority and get it listed. So let's get cracking into these shelves. All right, so I'm looking this over, and I'm trying to figure out what shelf to start with. I'm going to save the top one for the end because I know that's mostly sports cards. So that leaves the next four shelves. Honestly, these three right here just look too overwhelming right now. So I think I'm just going to start on that bottom shelf right there, because at least we've got a space there, and it looks more manageable. It looks like it's mostly books, and looks like maybe a comic book in there or something. So let's go in there first. Well, I just heard from my contractor. He literally just texted me. He must know I'm filming. And he told me he's going to start next week. Don't have a specific day yet, but this is going to get transformed really soon. So we've got to get to work here. All right. Well, this is a little awkward, but I got to get down here somehow, right? So let's take a look here. All right. Take a look at this. Haven't seen this in a while. I think I got this maybe at the flea market. Could have been an estate sale, but it's a Corona Extra 6-pack beer tote. Look at that dust is going in the air. It's how long it's been sitting there. So, okay, we've got that. It's summertime, so this might be a good time to put something like that out. Look at this. Now, this is perfect because I've actually been putting up a lot of pet stuff in my store, so this will go perfect. I have actually a couple of things that are fish related. So I've got, a heater on. I've got lighting equipment for aquariums listed. So this will be good. A gravel vacuum cleaner. Really cool. Now, I've always wanted a fish tank, by the way. The cleaning part of it is the problem. And I always told Mrs. Primetime I'd like to hire someone to come in and clean it, but she won't let that happen. So unless I clean the tank, which is not going to happen right now, we're not getting a fish tank. So now I remember where I got this. This was something I purchased. It just was kind of thrown in with a bunch of German books that I bought, old German books. And I still haven't sold any of them, so I'm not German, so I don't know much about this. I'd have to look into it a little bit more. But it looks like we've got someone of royalty, and this goes back to 1977. So cool little piece of ephemera there, and I'm sure this will have some, you know, appeal to somebody. So there's nothing that exciting going on in the bottom, but oh, look in the back. Oh, Sylvia and Victoria looks like. Look at that. There we go. There we got something on the back there as well. So that's pretty cool. So, you know, that's not a priority to list, but definitely a cool item. I'm gonna have to start sorting this stuff somehow, but I'll figure it out. Many of you have played this game. This is just something that Mrs. Primetime gave me when she was clearing out shelves, but who knew? So this one, I remember her telling me that this one's valuable because it comes in the metal tin. So I think they come in different formats, but this is all complete. So apparently it's a fun game. I don't remember ever playing it, but we'll just put this over here for now. Now we've got this little mystery box here, and this is the one where I knew there was some kind of comic up front, but if you like Star Wars, you probably love this because this is a, well, I think it's a comic. I don't know. Let me see. It's a Star Wars album, and it's in a bag. So let me pull it out of here and see what it looks like. Maybe this is actually just pictures from the movie and stuff. Maybe it's not even a comic. Oh, yeah. So you see, it's like, I don't want to damage the book. So let me just move up a little bit here so you can see. So it's, you know, pictures of the movie. It's black and white and color inside. It's in great condition. You can see here. So this is neat. There's, you know, C-3PO right there. Really cool piece. This one goes back to, you can actually see here, the copyright date of this actually is 1977. So this came out right around, you know, when the movie did. So awesome. Really cool. This is nice. I like this piece. So I'm going to keep this one out. This one I'm going to put in like a, I'm going to make, I think, separate piles, like a priority pile and one that's not priority. I think this one should go in a priority pile. I know I have lots of Star Wars fans that watch the channel. And so this one, we've got to make sure we get this one listed soon. Let's see. Some more comic books in here. This is just some random horror-related comics here called Terror. It's not a real, like, popular series or anything like that. They just seem to be randomly kind of thrown in there. Let's see if that's what all of these are. So let's see, we have issue number 2. I think this is going to be one of these things where we have everything but issue number 1, of course. Issue number 3, issue number 4. This has the look and feel of a 1990s comic book to it. You could tell with the prices being $1.75. Yeah, they're 1992. So there we go, number 6 and number 7, okay? So we've got the Punisher being integrated into here. And you could always tell the Punisher character because he's got this skull across his body on his outfits. Always look for that. He's, you know, wears black and white. So, okay. So I don't know what we'll do with that since we're missing issue number 1. So I probably have issue 1 somewhere. So I'm just going to set that aside for now. Not priority. This is a Civil War comic book right here. Very popular series. So it's a trade paperback. So we'll just put that to the side because I've got a lot of stuff like that. Futurama fans, looks like we've got a Futurama. Well, it looks like a Futurama. Yeah, it's a Futurama comic book right there. So we've got that. I know there's a lot of Futurama fans out there. Radioactive Man. Let's see. Radioactive Man. So there's a bunch of these. So a lot of like Simpson related ones. This one's damaged, so I might have to toss this one. We'll see. It's another Futurama comics. I remember where I picked this up. I picked this up at a garage sale. Futurama. Man, I didn't even notice stuff was down here. See, I need to integrate this with my comic book boxes. There's a lot of Futurama comics. Most of them are in great shape. There's that one that was damaged. But besides that, we have some duplicates here. So I'll have to decide what to do with that. Oh my God, my elbow is killing me sitting on this. I need to get something to put my elbow on. I'm on a solid cement floor. Hold on a second.
Frankenberry cereal is coming your way. How about the monster for breakfast today? That's probably the most you'll ever hear me sing. But I finally get to put this Frankenberry pillow to good use. Oh my God, that's so much better. Oh my goodness. All right. Jeez, I was gonna break my elbow doing this. Oh boy. All right, there we go. Number four. Got number seven. I didn't even see if we have number one in here. Let me go back. Number two. Oh yeah, we do. Well, one of two. So there's like a little mini series here. One of two. But then there should be a first. Here we go. Look at that. Number one issue right there. That's in great shape. So we do have that. We've got number eight. So it looks like we've got a little run here. So that's nice. We got number nine. We got number 10. This is a very popular series, folks. If you're not into comic books, don't worry about it. I'll still try to pass on some tips even when I come across comics, because Futurama is a very popular series. There's action figures that are made from Futurama. There's DVD sets made for the Futurama series. So definitely go and check anything out that you see Futurama. It is very collectible. So I absolutely love coming across it. And again, I remember getting this along with a bunch of other items, including, by the way, a Futurama action figure that I picked up with this lot and sold it. And I think I sold it for something like $70. It was the, I believe it was this robot down here that I wound up selling. So just a ton of it. So that's all the Futuramas. So it looks like we have about a stack of 23 Futurama comic books and other miscellaneous kind of Simpsons and, you know, stuff like that. So then we've got a few other kind of just random comic books. Got like a Captain America. Here's another little, it's like a little Captain America set. Captain America, The Death of the Dream. Let's see here. Okay, so it's issues 25, 26, and 27 right there. So we've got that. This is Truth Justin and the American Way. Just one of these weird kind of series through Image Comics, which, you know, with Image, this is the brand up here. Most of you are familiar with Marvel and DC. You know, Image is another, you know, like one of the independent rivals. And so this is probably all five comics in one. I'm not sure if there's, yeah, it's a total of five. Five of five right there. So you can see it's a complete set. So I love complete sets. That's one of the things you want to look for with comic books, complete sets, because they're so easy to comp. Unlike if you have, like, let's say 20 out of 50 issues of a comic book series, that's much more challenging to do comps on, but that is simple. So we just look up what sets of five like that have sold for before. Some more Captain America Civil War, more Captain America, Death of Captain America, and we've got some on the front and back here. So let's see, we've got another one here. So there's just a bunch of Captain America ones in here. So I just lot them together, mix them with my other Captain America comic books. We're almost done with this box right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna take the Captain America ones, I'm gonna integrate it into one of my other comic book boxes right now. I can't believe this. Not that it's an amazing series or anything, but let me go back to something I showed you earlier. Okay, now this, by the way, this is why I always say you have to check the bottom of the comic book boxes. Okay, so here's number two, right? We have number two, remember this? We've got number three, and it goes all the way to seven. I was like, well, maybe I have number one somewhere. Look at this. Number one laying right on the bottom. What are the chances of that? That is so cool. That is so cool. You just never know. So, all right, let me sort that out. Then I'll come back and we'll get to this stack. Okay, and just to give you some comps information about these Terror Inc. comic books, if I had all 13 of them, because it's a run of 13, that could be worth about $40. But seven of them, the first seven, actually just sold for right around $22. So that's just an important tip to pass on. You don't always have to have the complete set to sell it. It does help. But sometimes if you have a, you know, consecutive run of most of them, you could still sell that as well.
All right, so I just got back from taking some photographs of items that I've pulled out of here because I want to make sure that I get some of these things listed soon. Like I mentioned, the Star Wars book is a priority, so I already photographed that one. The Seven Terror Ink comic books I photographed. Also, I photographed the aquarium filter and that Corona beer pack. They were real easy to take pictures of very quick. And the rest of the stuff I just organized and put away. And you know who reminded me to do that? This little guy right here. That's right, another Pink Panther has arrived, again, courtesy of Troy Shockley from the Mountain Man Treasures YouTube channel and eBay store. He's been on my channel a few times. He's a super great guy. You should all go check him out. I'll put a link to his channel down below in the description section. He's got amazing content, so everyone should follow him. And he's just a great guy. You know, he saw the flood video and he said, you know I sent you that little Pink Panther guy, and but this, you know, he knew that it was just too much for him to handle, like to help me out. So he knew he needed some backup. So he said, I sent you over some reinforcements to help you out. So I really appreciate it. This Pink Panther, he's going to go up here and just, you know, continue to supervise things, and I'll just continue to move him around. One other thing I want to mention before we get into this shelf is just an update on something since we were just talking about comic books. Some of you may remember this who've been watching me for a while. If not, go back to the father-son sourcing video where my son, Primetime Jr., and I went over to a comic convention. And we just kept picking these out of a box and wound up getting about 25 of them or so for about 70 cents each. So I spent somewhere between like 15 and 20 bucks on them. And I've sold each one of them except one. This is the last one left, for between $27.50 and, you know, somewhere in the $40 range. I made out really well, like close to $1,000 on a $20 investment, just recognizing this particular book. And that's why I want to point it out to you. It's the last issue of The Deadly Hands of Kung Fu. So that's one of the reasons that it's popular, being the last issue. And also because there's a movie coming out about this particular series and this character, Shang-Chi. So just wanted to pass that on. Now we're going to get into the rest of these books. All right, so I did know that these were obviously some type of kids book. I thought they were Charlie Brown books from just looking from the top. You know, it says Bantam book here. But now I could see from the top here that these are Walt Disney books, and they are from the Fun to Read Library series. And, you know, based on what you can see on the back here, there's supposed to be 19 of the books. So I would assume that I have all 19 of them, because I don't think I would have picked this up. I just know how I think without the full set. So let's take a look here if they're all here. It looks like they are. There's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. So they're all here. So the question is, at this point, what are they worth? Let me look it up and let you know. All right, well, very good news is that these have regularly sold for right around $70 for the full set. And I would have gotten this for like a fraction of that at a garage sale or an estate sale or something. So that's going to be nice. And, you know, this is the stuff that kills me, is just knowing right now that, you know, I have like $70 sitting right here and I just haven't listed it. So, you know, I've got to, you know, like I said, get this stuff up faster. And so this is going to be something that I move out towards the garage so I see it more, and get that up hopefully pretty soon. Over here down below, these are some, it looks like some European books, which came from the collection where I got this German newspaper here. So there's a bunch of other German books, as you could see here. So that's a cool one. Here's an old atlas. I remember where I got these. I got these at an estate sale. The guy who had passed away had lived in Germany and had a bunch of relatives from Germany. So I wound up getting a lot of these things here. This one looks really cool. This is an old Renaissance book right here. And I totally forgot about this. I mean, look at this. This has like, here, let me sit up so I could show you this a little bit better. All right, so this book is fairly old. It was published in 1938. And when you open it up inside, you're going to see all this German writing. But even if you don't understand German, that's okay, because a picture speaks a thousand words. And you're going to see all of these basically hand-pressed on photos of old paintings. And for the vast majority of the pages here, these are still stuck on. There's a few of them that have come loose, but that's to be expected, you know, given the age. Like you could see this one here came loose, but it's still here. And on the back of them, actually, it does have a little description. You know, that would help identify where in the book it's supposed to go, you know, if it does fall off. So I think they, you know, must have anticipated that that sort of thing was going to happen. Now, it's not in perfect condition. You know, there's a few pages here where you could see there's like some crayon that got onto it, and it is loose from the binding. So what is it going to go for? I'm not sure. You know, it's not something that you could, you know, find on eBay right now. So hopefully someone will be interested in it because of the age and because of all those cool photos. If you're wondering what this stands for, I do speak fluent German. No, I'm just kidding. But this does stand for, based on the translation I was able to come up with, the Gothic and early Renaissance paintings. And so that's what the pictures there were showing. So I'm going to organize these, and then we're actually almost done with this shelf. We've got this little bag here and something behind it. So we'll get to that in just one second. I know you're probably wondering what's in the bag. So am I, but let's look at this Lennox piece behind it first. Then we'll get to the bag here. Let's see what is in this thing. It's probably some like wedding gift or something like that. Oh, I remember these. I don't remember where Mrs. Primetime got these. They are Lennox pieces here. So, you know, eventually I will list these. They're not a priority for me to list. So this is an example of what I mean. Like if someone saw these and said, oh, wow, I'd really like those, then, you know, I would list them for you. But otherwise, you know, they're going to just stay in here for a little bit. And, you know, I'll put it somewhere else for now just to get it off this shelf. But let's see what's in this bag here. There's not even much in here, whatever's in here. Oh, okay. So what we've got here are excess Wii controllers. So you can see here is like the paddle and stuff, and some other game control remotes and stuff. We've got some kind of like sharp camera. This is like a random thing. I don't even know why this wound up in here. I'm not sure what this goes to. I'm gonna have to check that out. That's weird. It's got like a plug here and everything. So I don't know. We're gonna have to look that up. And then we've got just some like, oh, look at this. We got like a red controller for the Wii right there. We've got a white controller. So I do have a Wii system in one of those other bags that you saw. I remember where I got these at a garage sale. And so these all go together. So I'll just keep it together with that other set. Kind of got separated from it a little bit being down there. But basically they're all video game accessories. And if you don't know, video game accessories, you could do well with. You could just sell the accessories by themselves, or of course you could pair them with the units and stuff. So, you know, we'll see. I'm gonna have to test this stuff out and stuff. Again, not a real priority for me right now, but at least we know what's in the bag. And now look at that, done with one shelf. So let's move up to the next one. I can finally get off this floor. All right, well, this mystery is solved. It is an alarm clock. I should have been able to figure that out because it has the word alarm right on the front. So I just didn't see that. Plus, it would be obvious from the back. But it just didn't look like an alarm clock. I guess that's what threw me off. You know, I'm sitting there with video game controller pieces, and I'm just thinking, you know, video game accessories. So you're just like in that mindset. So, but if you find this new, I checked the comps on it. It sells for $28. Obviously, it's not new. It's got some shelfware and stuff to it. So, you know, cut that price in half. So about 14 bucks or so. We'll go first class. Whatever I get out of it is good because I didn't even know I had it. And it was just thrown in with all that video game stuff. So it was just a toss-in item. So, you know, always check these things because this could be the type of thing that you just say, you just throw it out. You just think it's junk. But, you know, it turns out, you know, it actually has a little bit of value to it. So good job, Mr. Alarm Clock. All right, so I took out the video game stuff and I put it all in one section. There were several different bags, including this bag here, which had all of these video games in it. So I just pulled them out so I could see them. You know, there are some good games in here, like Super Mario Brothers Wii would definitely be the best one. Well, of course, there's the legendary Disney Princess Enchanted Journey game. I mean, this game is amazing. I'm just, but you know, there's some Just Dance games, and there's a hunting game there as well, which is what this gun comes from. So those two pieces just snap in together. And of course, you know, like I said, there's all these different accessories and stuff and controllers. So I'm going to put this all in one box. So I wound up eliminating that bag. There was another bag here. So now I don't have to worry about these dumb bags. That's all cleared for now. So I feel good. I feel like we actually accomplished something here. Awesome. Bye-bye, bags. Hello, box. All right, well, we obviously have more mystery unshelving to do. I think that the best treasures lay beyond on shelf number 2, shelf number 3, and shelf number 4. But I'm mindful of the length of the video, so I don't want to make the video any longer than this. So I'm going to keep filming and put up additional installments showing what was found on those shelves. So like I said, if there's something that you saw that you like, you know, make sure you let me know that. You can check out my eBay store. I'm going to be putting up some posts of some of these items tonight and maybe even tomorrow. If you just want to share with me and let me know what your favorite item was that that I found, let me know that as well. If you have any questions on anything, you know, let me know that too. So again, hope you enjoyed the video. Hit the like button, make sure you subscribe, and you know, stay tuned for the next ones. So it's gonna be a lot of changes in this space. I'm really, really excited about it. So that's it, folks. I'll see you at the next one. Take care.
Hey, you look up to no good. What are you doing? Where are you going? Was that your bunny? You're not interested in that right now. Where'd you go? You hiding under the table?
There you are. Where's your face? Where'd your face go?